You're watching the award-winning GHS-TV, a nationally recognized student television station. Hello, and welcome to Cable Quiz, the academic game show that challenges Germantown High School's brightest students. I'm your moderator, Caleb Suggs. Cable Quiz consists of 8 3-member teams that will test their knowledge on a variety of subjects. During each game, a red team and a white team will go head-to-head in this single elimination tournament. For this week, the red team members are Hannah Everhart, Christian Snipes, and Long Truong. Senior Hannah Everhart has been ensemble for the spring musicals The Little Mermaid and The Mystery of Edwin Drood. She is also in chorale and is a member of the National Latin Honor Society, Beta Club, and Tri-M. Junior Christian Snipes is a member of the Beta Club and Key Club, runs track and field, and is on the GHS cross-country team. In his spare time, Christian enjoys reading, playing video games, and playing guitar. Sophomore Long Truong is a Model UN member and plays in the GHS Varsity Band. Long enjoys music and plays multiple instruments. He was a part of the 2016 Tennessee All-State Band. For this week, the white team's members are Saba Rouhani, Nikhil Salian, and Noah Sims. Junior Saba Rouhani is a member of the Beta Club, Science National Honor Society, True Blue Memphis and National Honor Society, and the French Club. In his spare time, Saba enjoys playing soccer. Junior Nikhil Salian is a part of the soccer team, the swim team, National Honor Society, Beta Club, Model UN, and the GHS Band. In his spare time, Nikhil enjoys watching movies. Junior Noah Sims is a member of the International Club. In his spare time, Noah enjoys helping around his neighborhood, playing video games, and playing guitar. Now let's take time to review the Cable Quiz rules.
Contestants compete for toss-up and bonus questions. Toss-up questions are up for grabs and teams may not confer. Buzz in first, and you've got 5 seconds to answer. If you're wrong, members of the other team get a chance. But if you're right, your team gets 5 points and a bonus question. Teams work together on the bonus question to come up with an answer. Got the right answer? Your team gets 10 more points. Points are never deducted for incorrect answers. Towards the end of the game, there is a 3-minute lightning round in which every question is a 5-point toss-up. No bonus questions, no conferring. The team with the most points at the end of the lightning round wins.
In the case of a discrepancy, we will consult with our panel of judges, which today consists of Morgan Arant and Jordan Bernardini. Now let's begin our first round of competition. Remember, this round ends after 18 minutes. Timekeeper, please start the clock. Good luck to both teams. Question number one. The orbit of an object about a planet with significant atmosphere will decay because of what retarding force? Either team. White team. Excuse me, what?
Gravity.
Gravity is the wrong answer, so the red team has a chance to steal. Red team, your answer.
Inertia.
That's the bell, you're out of time. Do you have an answer?
Inertia?
Inertia is the wrong answer. We're looking for drag. Next question. These prose works all fit into what literary genre? Economics in One Lesson, The Frontier in American History, The Autobiography of Mark Twain. Red team.
Nonfiction.
Nonfiction is the right answer. Now you have a chance to earn 10 extra points in our bonus question. This is just for the red team, so white team, don't buzz in to answer this one. Here's your bonus question. This line is from what science fiction story? Speaking of waves, pet, by the way, there is such a thing as a tesseract. Time's up, you got an answer?
Treasure Island?
Incorrect, we're looking for A Wrinkle in Time. Back to our toss-up question, which is for both teams. After applying glaze, through what process does the surface of pottery become permanently non-porous? Red team.
Glazing.
Glazing. It's after applying glaze. So, white team, your chance to steal.
When the dough rises, I don't know.
We all do. About pottery.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. You shape it?
Got an answer?
When you put it in the oven. When you put it in the oven, baking it.
Baking. That is the wrong answer. We're looking for firing. You are on the right track. Our next toss-up question. While embargoes and economic sanctions are legal barriers to trade, what similar measure that prevents a nation from international trade is considered an act of war? Either team. You're out of time. Our answer was blockade. I know you want to answer. It's okay. Next question. Cardiologist, neurologist, and dermatologist are a few of the many health providers known as medical what? Red team.
Doctors?
Doctors. No. White team, you got an answer?
Professionals?
Professionals. No, we're looking for... You already gave an answer. That is the right answer, though. We're looking for specialists, but that doesn't count for you. Let's update our score. The red team is currently in the lead with a score of 5 to the white team 0. All right, so let's move on to our next toss-up question so maybe we can earn some points. What term referring to animals that feed on leaves and young shoots also indicates the kind of program used to surf the internet? White team.
Web.
Web. We're looking for another answer. Red team.
Herbivores.
Herbivores. No, we're looking for browser. All right, next toss-up. The World Cup was much in the news in 2014. This tournament is run by FIFA. What do most Americans call the sport that FIFA regulates? That's the white team.
Soccer.
Soccer, that's right. All right, so you're matching the red team now with a score of 5-5. Let's earn 10 extra points. What are the first 5 words in the rhyme in which a horseshoe is lost, a knight is lost, a battle is lost, and a kingdom is lost?
No.
Do you have an answer?
Nope.
No, I didn't.
You don't. Well, our answer was for want of a nail. Back to our toss-up questions. The summits of Gannett Peak and Grand Teton are the 2 highest points in what state? White team.
Wyoming.
Wyoming, that's right. All right, so your bonus question. This is from a geometric parody of what poem? 'Twas Euclid and the Theorem of Pi, did plain and solid in the text, all parallel were the radii, and the angles convexed.
That sounds like something Shakespeare wrote. Like, nice. Like we know it's a parody. It's something we've heard.
Answer?
We're gonna know this.
No answer?
No answer.
No answer.
Jabberwocky, that's our answer. All right. Next toss up, this is a math question, so you might want to get those pads out. With this one, because it is a math question, you will get 15 seconds to confer an answer. Our math question, what is the supplement of an angle of 140 degrees?
40 degrees.
White team, that is correct. That was fast. Did you just know that off the top of your head?
Yeah.
Huh. All right, so let's update our score before this bonus question. The white team is now in the lead with a score of 15 to the red team's 5, so you caught up. All right, so your bonus question. What quadrupedal Australian marsupial herbivore has these characteristics as an adult? Length of about 1 meter, short stubby tail, short legs, rodent-like front teeth, powerful claws for digging, backwards-facing pouch. You don't have to buzz in, that was your question, but what's your answer?
Armadillo.
Armadillo, we're looking for wombat.
Okay, I just guessed.
That's okay. All right, so your toss-up question. What country that ceased to exist in 1991 was represented by the hammer and sickle? That's the white team.
The Soviet Union.
Soviet Union, that's our answer.
Nice.
All right, white team, your bonus question again. Completed in 1825. The construction of what artificial waterway tremendously reduced transport costs, encouraged a population surge in western New York, opened areas farther west to settlement, and enabled New York City to become the main U.S. port?
Yeah, but it could still... Sea. You said Hudson Bay. Hudson Bay?
Hudson Bay. No, we're looking for Erie Canal. But let's update our score. The white team is still in the lead with a score of 20 to the red team's 5. All right, your next toss-up question. What kind of heat transfer can only occur within an object or between two objects that are in contact with each other? White team.
Is it convection? Convection?
Convection?
Yeah.
That's not the right answer. Red team, your chance to steal.
Conduction?
Conduction, that's the right answer. All right, red team, you get a bonus question and a chance to tie up with the white team. All right, so your bonus question. Name the process of drilling and injecting fluid into the ground at high pressure to break up shale rock and release the natural gas it holds.
Fracking?
Fracking, that's the right answer. All right, so our score is tied 20 to 20. It's still anyone's game. In 2014, after being downed by a missile, the remains of the MH17 and its passengers were strewn over an 8-mile stretch of what troubled country?
What did you say the year was?
The year was 2014. White team.
Syria?
Syria. We're looking for another answer. Red team.
Ukraine.
Ukraine?
Ukraine. That's the right answer. All right, so your bonus question. Because of the color of their uniforms, from the 17th century to the early 19th century, soldiers of the British Army were called what?
Redcoats.
Redcoats, that's the right answer. In your bonus question, you don't have to buzz because that's just for you. But I see that you're eager, so that's good. All right, so let's update the score. The red team is in the lead now with a score of 35 to the white team's 20. Next toss-up, the sinking of an American warship in Havana Harbor in 1898 was used to encourage the start of what war? White team.
The Spanish-American War.
Spanish-American War, that's the right answer. All right, your bonus question. What kind of buffalo that is found throughout South and East Asia is vital to the existence of more human beings than any other domesticated animal?
Could you repeat the question?
Yes, I can repeat the question.
Sorry.
What kind of buffalo that is found throughout South and East Asia is vital to the existence of more human beings than any other domesticated animal?
Water buffalo?
Water buffalo, that's right.
No.
Now we are tied again with a score of 35 to 35. All right, next question. What term for sharp, stubby twigs on woody plants also indicates the spiked wheels sometimes worn by cowboys to urge their mounts forward? That's the red team.
Spurs.
Spurs, that's right. Red team, you take the lead again. Now, bonus question. It is the 8th least populous, but the 2nd most densely populated of the U.S. states. Name this state bordered by Connecticut, Massachusetts, and the Atlantic.
It's either New York or New Jersey.
Out of time, you got an answer?
New York.
New York. Sorry, we were looking for Rhode Island. All right, your toss-up question. A novel is often used as the basis for a film. What is the term for such recasting of original material into a new form? White team.
Rendition.
Rendition, no. Red team.
Greenplay?
Reboot. We were actually looking for adaptation. Oh, did you say that one before?
No, we just...
That's cool. No, our next toss-up question. What foreign policy ism is illustrated by Japan's 20th century annexations of Korea, Manchuria, Cambodia, Vietnam, Thailand, and the Philippines? That's the white team.
Imperialism?
Imperialism, that's the right answer. Your bonus question. When the Lewis and Clark expedition began its return trip from the mouth of Columbia River, their destination was what Midwest city that had been their point of departure?
St. Louis.
St. Louis, that's the right answer.
No.
The white team takes the lead again with a score of 50 to the red team's 40. So our next toss-up, what sweeping series by Robert Jordan chronicles the struggle between servants of the Dark One and the champions of light called the Dragon Reborn? At a time, we're looking for the Wheel of Time. Next question. After the Holocaust, there was a marked increase in Jewish migration to the British Protectorate of Palestine, which became what modern state? That's the white team.
Israel.
Israel. That's the right answer.
Thank you, Abdallah.
All right, so your bonus question. At least one historian claims that a legendary contest involving what central character could not have occurred at the Big Ben Tunnel because railroad records do not show a steam drill being used there. You're out of time. You're lucky you had something.
Johnny Appleseed?
Is it John Henry?
John Henry. That's right. Oh, our next toss-up. The monkey's paw in the story by W.W. Jacobs has powers similar to what object in one of the tales from the Arabian Nights? That's okay. Take your time. You have 5 seconds. You're out of time. We're looking for Aladdin's lamp. How many two-digit number palindromes are there? White team.
10.
10. No, that's incorrect. Red team, your answer?
9.
That's the right answer. All right, so your bonus question. In Dickens' A Christmas Carol, Scrooge is visited by the ghost of Christmas yet to come and sees his future. This literary technique is called flash what? That's the bonus question for the red team. You can't buzz in.
My bad.
I see you're ready to play, though. That's good. I'll read it again since you were interrupted. In Dickens' A Christmas Carol, Scrooge is visited by the ghost of Christmas yet to come and sees his future. This literary technique is called flash what? That's the bell. Got an answer?
Flash forward?
Flash forward is the correct answer. Let's update our score. The white team is still in the lead with 65 to the red team's 55. Next question. What kingdom was established by the subjugation of the smaller independent chiefdoms of Maui, Molokai, Lanai, Kauai, and Oahu? That's the red team.
Hawaii.
Hawaii, that's right. Your bonus question. Charles Dickens considered Little Fred and Tiny Mac as names for a character in A Christmas Carol before choosing what other name?
Tiny Tim.
Tiny Tim, that's right. All right, so the red team has taken the lead over the white with 70 to 65. Next question. Monometallism indicates an economy based on a gold as a standard for its monetary system. What term indicates an economy based on both gold and silver? Either team? White team.
Would it be dual metallism?
Dual metallism. That's incorrect. Red team, you can steal.
Bimetallism?
Bimetallism. That's what we're looking for. All right, so your bonus question. These are all varieties of what meteorological phenomenon? Superbolt. Staccato, sheet, ribbon, dry, heat, bead, ball, rocket, and sympathetic.
Lightning?
Lightning, that's right. All right, so our toss-up question. According to a lease signed more than a century ago, the U.S. pays Cuba $4,085 per month for the land occupied by what naval base and military prison? Red team.
Guantanamo Bay.
Guantanamo Bay. You got that right. You slammed that down really hard.
Sorry.
Is your hand okay? Yeah, okay. All right, let's update the score one more time. The red team is in the lead with a score of 90 to the white team's 65. Next question, your bonus question. These are examples of what kind of coordinated action by the labor force? In 1902, 147,000 coal miners quit working. In 1959, 500,000 steel workers left their jobs. In 1970, 210,000 postal workers stopped delivering mail.
Striking.
Strikes, that's right. Toss-up question. DOF is a measure of how much of the area in front of and behind the subject of a photo is in focus. For what does this abbreviation stand for? White team.
Depth of field.
That's right.
Nine.
All right, so your bonus question, white team. When Sony's laptops were found to be a fire hazard, or when General Motors cars were found to have faulty ignitions, the companies requested the return of those products for repairs and parts replacement. What is the term for such requests?
Recall.
Recall, that's right, you were confident. All right, the red team is still in the lead with a score of 100 to the white team's 80, but anyone can still take this game. What constellation near Aquarius and Andromeda is named for a Greek mythological winged steed? White team.
Pegasus.
Pegasus, that's the right answer.
Nice.
Your bonus question. What British author wrote this? Clearly, the time traveler proceeded, any real body must have extension in four directions. It must have length, breadth, thickness, and duration.
H.G. Wells?
H.G. Wells, that's right.
Oh,
thank you. Toss up, what kind of precipitation is characterized by elevated levels of hydrogen ions caused by emissions of sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide? That's the white team.
Wait, what? Say it.
Acid rain?
Acid rain, that's right. That ties up our score at 100 to 100. So your bonus question, oh, sorry, we're out of time. That bell means the first part of the game is now over. We're currently tied with a score of 100 to 100. But when we come back, our Fast and Furious 3-minute lightning round will determine today's champion. Please stay with us.
Welcome to Germantown High School, an international baccalaureate creative and performing arts optional school, a destination school for students who are going places.
Our students are of the highest caliber when it comes to their academics and knowledge.
The IB program is a very rigorous program.
You were challenged in a way that you thought you couldn't be challenged. You succeeded something that other kids may not have thought they could do.
They're accepted to colleges that are just, I mean, dream colleges for so many people.
Germantown High School offers a CAPA program, the Creative and Performing Arts program.
When I first came here, I saw the television studio and I was just amazed at what all I saw.
Kids do everything, that they're taught every detail that has to do with theater arts and creative arts.
I love a lot of things about Germantown High School, but primarily what I love is the athletics. There's something exciting around every single corner.
We probably are one of the most diverse high schools in the state of Tennessee, maybe the United States.
I would never doubt about sending your child to Germantown High School.
This high school is something not like any other high school that we have.
There's definitely fun in the work. We find fun in everything we do.
You're watching the award-winning GHS-TV, a nationally recognized student television station.
Welcome back to Cable Quiz. I'm your moderator, Caleb Suggs. Today we have the red team consisting of Hannah Everhart, Christian Snipes, and Long Truong competing against the white team, made up of Sabah Rahani, Nakhil Salian, and Noah Sims. Now before the lightning round, let's take a moment to talk about what happens to our Cable Quiz contestants after Cable Quiz is completed. Our faculty sponsors will select permanent members of the Germantown High School academic team from the Cable Quiz contestants. Members of the academic team are eligible for Knowledge Bowl. Winners in Knowledge Bowl are awarded savings bonds or scholarship money as they advance through the citywide competition. Once again, let's repeat our score. We are tied with a score of 100 to 100. Contestants, we will now move on to the 3-minute lightning round. Every question is a toss-up worth 5 points. There's no conferring and no bonus points. Listen up, because these are going to come really fast. Timekeeper, will you please start the clock? Now, for question number one, name the line that is pulled to deploy a parachute or to release gas from a balloon. White team.
The release?
No. We're looking for ripcord. I'm sorry. Why is the term jellyfish a misnomer? Red team.
They aren't fish.
That's right. A parachute slows the descent of a falling object by creating what force that retards motion?
Draft.
Draft. No, we're looking for drag. What country on Europe's Iberian Peninsula has the largest population? That's the white team.
Spain.
Spain, that's right. Next question, what is the name for a burn caused by a hot liquid or steam? Either team. Red team.
Scalding?
Scald, that's right. Most people living in Benghazi are of what nationality? Either team. We're looking for Libyan. What vast Asian structure is sometimes called the longest graveyard in the world? That's the white team.
The Great Wall of China?
That's right. What is the largest country that includes the Ural Mountains? Red team.
Russia.
Russia, that's the correct answer. The boiling point of water is highest in what American national park? Either team. White team.
Yellowstone?
No, we're looking for Death Valley. What body of American delegates convened in 1774 in response to the Intolerable Acts? Red team.
Constitutional Convention?
That is correct. The abbreviation for what constellation of the zodiac is PSC? Red team.
Pisces.
That's right. What means of propulsion was used by these famous vessels? Endurance, Mayflower, Cutty Sark, and Golden Hind. White team.
Wind.
Wind, that's right. Not backed by gold or silver, name the paper money issued by the Continental Congress. Either team. White
team. Cash.
Cash, no, we're looking for Continentals. In the American legal system, until a defendant is proven guilty, he is presumed to be what? Red team.
Innocent.
Innocent, that's right. These words came into English from what language? Mana, lanai, mahi-mahi, and luau. Red team.
Hawaiian.
Hawaiian, yeah. The phrase tingling and numbness in the extremities indicates what parts of the body? Red team.
The extremities?
The extremities. No, we're looking for hands and feet. What U.S. president took the brunt of the blame for the economic collapse in 1929? That's the white team.
Hoover.
Herbert Hoover, that's the right answer. The Tagus River pretty much bisects what country on the Iberian Peninsula? White team.
Spain.
Spain. No, we're looking for Portugal. What state entered the Union on the same day as South Dakota? Red team.
North Dakota.
North Dakota, that's right. What is the main product of the desalination process?
Salt.
Salt. No, we're looking for water. Oh. And that bell means that the lightning round is now over, and this edition of Cable Quiz has unfortunately come to an end. The score shows that the red team is victorious over the white team with a score of 140 to 120. That means that the red team will advance to our final round of competition. Congratulations, red team, you did pretty good. If you would like more information about this or any other show on GHS-TV, please visit our website at ghstv.org. I'm Caleb Suggs. And on behalf of all of us here at GHS-TV, Germantown High School Television, thanks for watching. And we hope to see you again next week for another edition of Cable Quiz.